Hello everyone, welcome to the series of Java programming. In this video we are discussing abstract class and abstract method in Java. First of all, we will see some properties of abstract class. An abstract class object cannot be created. If a class has at least one abstract method, then that class must be declared as abstract class. Okay? Then abstract class can contain both abstract and non-abstract method, and an abstract method has no body. So these are some properties. Okay, we will discuss each one by one. This is an abstract class. How is it abstract? If we are writing a keyword abstract before a class, we can call it as an abstract class. Abstract class have abstract method. Okay, or if there is an abstract method in the class, we have to define that class as abstract. The next property we have discussed is abstract method should not have body. So this is abstract method and it doesn't have any body. Okay, now an abstract class can have non-abstract methods also. So this is a non-abstract method in the abstract class. Okay, now this is a inherited class. We can call it as abstract child, which is extended from abstract class. Here we have defined a main void m1. Okay, so this is the m1 method. Then next we have defined m3 method. Okay, now next is class abstract test. This is a main class. In main class we have created object of this child class. After creating object of child class, we have called this object obj.m2. That is this m2 method we have called. Okay, obj.m2, obj.m3 and obj.m1. So whenever we are calling this obj.m2 method, obj.m2 method is not there in this abstract child class, but child class is inherited from abstract class. So the code of method m2 will be available in this abstract child class, and that's why we can say that this m2 method which is available in the abstract class will be accessible here. Then at next statement we have called obj.m3, so which is there in child class, which will be accessible. And then we have called obj.m1, which is again there in the child class, so that will be available to use. So here the output will be m2 method of abstract class, m3 method of child class and m1 method of child class. This will be the output. And we can say that here an object of abstract class cannot be created. So we have not created any object of abstract class. We have created object of the child class, and child class have inherited the abstract class. That's why it is accessible. So this is a concept behind abstract class and abstract method in Java. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to see more videos on this topic.